accountability? Are they willing to assume that they're responsible? But you have an opportunity to fix it. Black women played a crucial part in voting the Biden administration into office. Now, I don't know if you know, brother, but more black women went out to vote for Joe Biden than they did Barack Hussein Obama. I wouldn't have done the research on it.
Wow.
90% of the black female vote went to Joe Biden over Trump. 90%. The state of Georgia. The good old state of Georgia. 67% black women. They organize for the Biden administration. So if you put this man in office, you're responsible for the same man, so-called black man, that was your boyfriend, your husband, and so on and so forth, that won't be able to get a just over broke, a job. He's going to get laid off. Guess why? Because they're going to replace him with a migrant. Now, you can think it's funny all you want to, but that's what these are the effects, man. They're going against all sorts of labor laws and everything for these migrants. So now, if you was one of these corporations, and we know how these corporations function, my good brother Kadar, they want a buck. So if you're one of these corporations and you could, someone that just came from Coconut Island and they came to what seems to be heaven to them, huh? And they're willing to work because where they came from, they didn't have no jobs. That's why they left their country. Listen, when people leave countries like that in massive numbers, there's a reason they want to leave, huh? So now, they come here to live the American dream. And the American citizens are living the American nightmare. And we could thank the black females for showing up in the polls in 2020 in record numbers, putting the Biden administration in the office. Now we have migrants in the hood around a lot of those black women. Same, a lot of these black women are complaining now. I was reading an article where the black women was taking all. They said, yeah, we have been the leaders of the black community. I say, they believe that. Leave them out there. That's fine by me. Can't play the race card with me, man. I'm going to call wrong where I see wrong and right where I see right. And you're responsible on a large scale for what's occurring in this country right here. Your decision-making process. Let's call it that. You say, oh, well, tell us about, I didn't know Joe. Well, yeah. You know what I think really inspired it, Kadar, was Kamala Harris, right? Feminism is so great in Eve's mind. It's not that they wanted Biden so much, right? It's that they wanted a woman in. They was hoping, remember all the rumors they were saying, Biden's so old, he's going to crook over and a so-called black woman is going to be sworn into office as the president of the United States Corporation. Remember that? He's still kicking, boy. He's still cooking, though. You remember that 1 foot?
Yeah,
that was the hope. But now look. Let me tell you something, man. Now, I'm going to tell you guys something. I can't make up. When Trump was in office, right? You know what I told you, Terrence? When Trump was in office, the foul-mouthed Kahan earned more than he ever did in his life. You know what I told you? When Trump was in office, the foul-mouthed Kahan earned more than he ever did. All kind of things came with Joey. What kind of things came with Joey, man? And the black woman jumped on the bandwagon. What you think about this, Terrence? What say if you? Did you know that there was not black women voted for the Biden administration? 90% of them voted for Biden over Trump. Now you tell me, how in the hell was she not responsible for what's going on? You know what, one woman, I read one article, the so-called black woman was saying, black women have been the spearhead of social justice movement throughout American history. What other woman says, what other woman disrespects her man like that? Talk back to me, TC. What other woman you know disrespects her man like that?
Well, brothers. I hate to be the bearer of bad news, but Eve just fell for the banana in the tailpipe. So,
well,
man.
If she fell for it, you make sure all the windows are rolled up. Huh? You know what I told you? Make sure all the windows are rolled up. They said black women have been the spearhead of the social justice movement throughout America. 100 years after the passage of the 19th Amendment, Vice President Kamala Harris, honored by black women. They say black women have proven to be the backbone of democracy. Y'all knew that? They're the backbone of democracy, huh? Let me show you how naive the black woman is. Don't you know it was the Democrats that instituted the system of slavery? Y'all know that? Y'all realize that? It was democracy that instituted the entire system of slavery. I guess they put that in a book. Because not enough black women seem to know that. The backbone of democracy, man. Now, did you know, Terrence, that black women played a crucial role in securing the Biden's victory in the 2020 election? So, the foul-mouthed Kahan figured it was time that he recognized and allow the black woman to celebrate their impact for shaping the future that we're now living in with the migrant problem in the United States. So, with that being said, with Biden in office, Kamala Harris in office, would you say things has gotten better or worse, Terrence? See the scandal that was going on in that, Terrence? They used the word black as a front. Huh? 90% of black women voted for President-elect Joe Biden over Donald Trump. Making the black woman, the Democrats' most loyal bloc. It was a black woman that was the deciding factor that put Biden in office. I'm gonna hit you with something, man. According to statistics, for the past five president cycles, they've shown up to the polls at higher rates than any other group. Did you?